Hello, hi guys. Here we are today, Italian, first of all. Italian listening 7, Philosophia Greco-Romana, Bardaishan of Edessa. Bardaishan of Edessa, philosopher or theologian? Bardaishan di Edessa, filosofo o teologo? I'm very enticed, interested in the cradle of civilization area, no? Mesopotamia, Syria, and so it's Greece, you know. And in fact, Bardaishan or Bardaishan depends from where I Edessa, it was a poet, philosopher, thinker of ancient Greece, and he was born and living in Edessa, that is on the northern part of Greece. I invite you to dig in this. It's very, very interesting. Why I've chosen this one? Because I am sono sempre alla ricerca. I am always in search of answers to my atheism belief. Okay. It's a bit controversial, because if I'm atheist, I cannot believe, you know. So is, but I'm very open-minded, so I like anyway to inquire, even if I became totally an atheist. Okay, but I'm still open to understand the real knowledge, you know, to finding, looking for answer to so many questions that I have at my age. And I found this article very, very interesting. This is something about boundary in between philosophy and theology. And since I discovered that this Bardaishan, this Edessa, is located in one of my top favorite areas on the planet Earth, because identifying exactly one of those places to be considered like the cradle of the humanity, no? Like Mesopotamia, the Tigris, Euphrates, you know, and then even more that is on the northern part of Greece, boundary with Macedonia. I'm even more intrigued about that. That's why I've chosen this. And this Mr. Ute Possekel, I don't know how to pronounce exactly, he just wrote about this debate, but Bardaishan was more a philosopher or more a theologian, and this is very, very interesting. So let's dig in. In order to, it's just an extract, because the article is very long. I just extracted the most interesting, the focus. In order to gain a better understanding of Bardaishan thought, per avere una comprensione più approfondita del pensiero di Bardaishan, Oh, guys, I tell you in advance, this level of language is definitely higher. Okay, so it took to me more time to translate as close as possible, but keeping a good English. And also in Italian, I mean to say the reverse, in Italian, it took a bit to me to how to translate in a way that really shows the meaning, because it's a bit difficult, you know, the argument by itself. So I change a lot in the Italian translation. Okay, so we will check something. This paper, in order to gain a better understanding of Bardashian thought, per avere una comprensione più approfondita del pensiero di Bardashian, or del Bardashian. In Italy say of Bardashian, okay, without the article, but in Italian, in history and literature, when we are talking of a prominent person, you know, a celebrity, we used to say il Bardashian. It's a form of respect, you know. This paper will investigate the question whether he's more appropriately designated a philosopher or a theologian. In questa ricerca vedremo di identificare con precisione il Bardashian come filosofo oppure come teologo by exploring four sub-questions. First, how was Bardashian educated? And how did he see himself? Ponendo quattro quesiti aggiuntivi. Punto primo. Il percorso educativo del Bardashian e come raffigurava la sua identità. Second, was his thought system, his doctrine, more akin to that of late antique philosophers or theologians? Punto secondo, la sua sfera di pensiero, la sua dottrina, erano più predisposti verso i filosofi o i teologi del tardo antico periodo, 180-192, after Christ, D.C., dopo Cristo, after Christ, and between 180 and the 7th century, 700. Third, did Bardashian formulate his ethical standards on a philosophical or a theological basis? Punto terzo. Third, Bardashian ha stabilito i suoi standard etici su basi filosofiche o teologiche? And fourth, did the social structure of Bardashian's community more closely resemble that of a philosophical school? Or that of a religious community? That is very interesting. I really like this one. I am the mo most interested in this, you know. That's why I've chosen this, I've extracted this part from the whole article. E punto quarto, la comunità della struttura sociale, secondo il concetto del Bardashian, rappresenta quella tipica della scuola filosofica o diversamente quella di una comunità religiosa? Finally, conclusions will be drawn from the preceding analysis. possiamo a questo punto poter trarre le conclusioni alle analisi fatte. Guys, in this translation, will is not shall, is not must, is not a confirmation, you know, a final confirmation where we can really say that we can reach the conclusions, okay? Be well defined. So I've added poter trarre, we may, we can, okay? Because it's not exactly a confirmation, okay? But before turning to Bardeshar, a few remarks on the terminology are in order. In Italian we cannot translate, ma prima di ritornare a Bardeshar, yeah, we can, but in this case we omit before. Ma ritornando al Bardeshan, alcune osservazioni, a few remarks, sulla terminologia usata sono d'obbligo. In the Greco-Roman world, philosophy and theology overlapped and competed with one another. Nel mondo greco-romano, filosofia e teologia erano in netto contrasto e in competizione tra loro. Philosophers thought themselves taught, sorry, sometimes I forget the proper pronunciation, because thought is pensiero, taught is insegnare, no? To taught, with a closed O, taught themselves to be the true theologians, and theologians claim to teach the true philosophy. Se da un lato i filosofi affermavano con orgoglio di essere i veri teologi, questi ultimi invece si vantavano di essere maestri depositari, custodian della vera filosofia. Philosophers asked about the origin of the cosmos, about its first cause, and identified this as God. I filosofi si interrogavano, in Italian became intransitive, no? Sull'origine del cosmo, della sua origine, e lo impersonificavano in Dio. They criticized the polytheistic mythological religious traditions. Criticavano le tradizioni religiose, politeistiche e mitologiche, which were thought to be incompatible with the notion of the one God as the ultimate cause of the universe, so the monotheist religion, no? Ritenendole incompatibili con il pensiero monoteista, unico in grado di supportare l'origine dell'universo. Ancient philosophy offered knowledge understood as scientific knowledge. La filosofia antica generava conoscenza intesa come sapere scientifico. And it taught how to live a morally good life. E insegnava le fondamenta di una vita moralmente ottimale. Philosophy is quintessentially the inquiry of autonomous human reason. I love this. La filosofia identificava perciò l'intima ricerca della sfera umana. And it remains so even when it asks about a transcendent reality. E così permane anche di fronte ad una realtà trascendentale. and thereby takes on a theological dimension, e per contrasto si eleva ad una dimensione teologica. Okay, guys, so as I told you, I've changed a lot in the Italian, because really it needed this, because the concept, the philosophical, theoretical concept are, you know, they require much more precision, you know, when translated in Italian, because the two languages are very quite different, you know, when it comes to express this kind of level concept. Okay, so let's read again only in Italian, okay, the whole. Bardeshan di Edessa, filosofo o teologo, per avere una comprensione più approfondita del pensiero di Bardeshan, in questa ricerca vedremo di identificare con precisione il Bardeshan come filosofo oppure come teologo, ponendo quattro quesiti aggiuntivi, secondari. Punto primo, il percorso educativo del Bardeshan e come raffigurava la sua identità. Punto secondo, la sua sfera di pensiero, la sua dottrina, erano più predisposti verso i filosofi o i teologi del tardo antico periodo, periodo compreso tra il 180 e il 700 dopo Cristo, after Christ. Punto terzo, Bardeshan ha stabilito i suoi standard etici, la sua etica, su basi filosofiche o teologiche? E punto quarto, per finire, la comunità della struttura sociale, secondo il concetto di Bardeshan, rappresenta quella tipica della scuola filosofica o diversamente quella di una comunità religiosa? Possiamo a questo punto poter trarre le conclusioni alle analisi fatte. Ma ritornando al Bardeshan, alcune osservazioni sulla terminologia usata sono d'obbligo, must be done, to better clarify some points. Nel mondo greco-romano, filosofia e teologia erano in netto contrasto e in competizione tra loro. Se da un lato i filosofi affermavano con orgoglio di essere i veri teologi, questi ultimi, the theologians, invece si vantavano di essere maestri depositari, custodian della vera filosofia. Philosophers asked about I filosofi si interrogavano sull'origine del cosmo, della sua origine, e lo impersonificavano in Dio. Criticavano le tradizioni religiose, politeistiche e mitologiche, ritenendole incompatibili con il pensiero monoteista, tipico del cristianesimo ad esempio, unico in grado di supportare l'origine dell'universo. La filosofia antica generava conoscenza intesa come sapere scientifico e insegnava le fondamenta di una vita moralmente ottimale, buona. La filosofia identifica perciò l'intima ricerca della sfera umana, e così permane anche di fronte ad una realtà trascendentale, e per contrasto si eleva ad una dimensione teologica. Guys, I want also to that you note that during reading history, especially in this way, you may, and you want to resume, okay, in Italian, you may easily change the the tense. For example, in English, the whole paragraph is written at the past tense. In Italian, it's different. Sounds different because you may even use, because when it's something related to a thought, to a period, a determined period that still permanent, still can be related to the nowadays era, you may quite easy shift from past tense to the present tense, okay? Because it's something that is still nowadays is keeping those parameters, you know, those values, okay? So remember, this is important. Okay, guys. Thank you very much. I hope that I boost your interest and curiosity in choosing this very particular argument. Okay, to me it's very important because I have a great passion for anthropology and the evolution. Based on the anatomy, evolution, and most of all about the cultural, okay, evolution. So I am always looking for some interesting articles regarding located in those area that historically are considered the cradles of the civilization, okay, both from an evolutional side and from a cultural side also, you know. So I hope that I give you some input to get deep and research about these things that are some of my main interest in life. All right, va bene. Okay, guys, remember, okay, try to dub my voice, okay, imitating my tone, my, okay, and try to also to get deep in how I translate, okay. This lesson is a bit more difficult than the others, okay, because it's required from the kind of from the subject. I mean, you know, we are talking of philosophy, so you know what, it says it all. All right, guys, thank you very much. See you next. Bye. Ciao.